At this stage, let us revise the various breath sounds that we have heard. Vesicular breath sounds. Harsh vesicular breath sounds. Bronchovesicular breath sounds. Vesicular breath sounds with prolonged expiration. Bronchial breath sounds. Cavernous bronchial breath sounds. Tubular bronchial breath sounds. Amphoric bronchial breath sounds. Now let us turn our attention to the adventitious or added sounds produced in the lung tissue, bronchi or pleura. These are abnormal sounds superimposed on the breath sounds and usually indicate disease. There are three main types of adventitious sounds added to the breath sounds: bronchi, rales and pleural rub. Bronchi or wheezes or dry sounds are commonly heard in patients with bronchial asthma. They are continuous musical sounds heard commonly during expiration. They may also be heard during inspiration or both inspiration and expiration. When the airway is obstructed by spasm, secretions or mucosal edema, the opposing airway walls at points where they are just touching each other vibrate like the reed of a toy trumpet and a musical sound is produced. These bronchi may be high-pitched or low-pitched, inspiratory, expiratory or both, short or long, and single or polyphonic. Listen to the high-pitched expiratory bronchi. Listen to the high-pitched inspiratory bronchi. Listen to the bronchi in both inspiration and expiration. Occasionally, in a patient with severe obstructive lung disease, the wheezing may disappear because he can no longer force enough air with enough force through the narrowed bronchi to produce wheezing. Hence, disappearance of wheezing in such a patient may be a bad sign. Rales or crackles or crepitations are sharp, non-musical, interrupted sounds like the sound produced by opening a Velcro patch. Rales are called moist sounds and have been attributed in the past to the sound of air bubbling through the secretions in the airways. This theory of production of rales, however, holds true only in case of coarse rales produced by secretions in the trachea and large bronchi, as in chronic bronchitis, bronchiectasis or lung abscess, and in patients who cannot cough up their secretions. These coarse rasps may be heard during inspiration or expiration, and more commonly at the end of inspiration. They may be altered or displaced by the act of coughing. The fine rasps or crackling rasps or fine crepitations are very fine and multiple sounds occurring transiently at the end of inspiration and have a crackling quality. They are localized and constant and not displaced by coughing. They are produced by sudden separation of the alveolar walls at the end of inspiration by the air rushing into the deflated areas of the lung. Let us listen to the fine rasps or crepitations at the end of inspiration. These fine rasps are seen in early pneumonia, early pulmonary tuberculosis, atelectasis or collapse of the lung, pulmonary fibrosis, pulmonary edema, and pulmonary congestion over dependent areas in bedridden patients. Latent or faint rasps can be best elicited by asking the patient to cough and listening carefully during the deep inspiration that follows a bout of cough. They are termed as post-tussive rasps. Pleural rub. Normally, the pleural surfaces move smoothly and noiselessly against each other during respiration. But when the pleura is inflamed, as in acute dry pleurisy, before any inflammatory fluid collects as effusion, the two inflamed and roughened surfaces of the pleura rub against each other and produce a creaking, grating sound termed as pleural rub or friction rub. It is commonly heard over the low axillary region where the movement between the parietal and visceral pleura is maximum. Sometimes it is apical in pulmonary tuberculosis and rarely all over one side of the chest. Listen to the pleural rub, which has a rubbing or creaking quality like the creaking sound of new leather, and is of loud intensity and superficial nature, sounding very close to the ear. It is heard in both inspiration and expiration, and if very loud, it may even be palpable. The pleural rub differs from the rasps in that it is loud and superficial, it is localized to a small area, it is accentuated by pressing the chest piece firmly on the chest wall and is unaltered by coughing. It is often accompanied by local pain and tenderness. Pleural rub is heard only during the first 1 or 2 days of pleurisy. Once the surfaces are separated by fluid, they no longer produce a rub. Sometimes, extraneous sounds not arising in the chest may be heard and confused with crepitations or pleural rub. For example, in subcutaneous emphysema, crackling sounds may be produced by pressure on the air in the subcutaneous tissues. And in a hairy patient, friction between the chest piece and hair may produce crepitation-like sound.